Hi, I'm Dave.
And I'm Craig.
And this is the Wizard product review for this week. Now, we haven't got any products on this week's show because we're filming this a week before Blackpool, because we're going to be in Blackpool next week. And this is the Blackpool highlight show.
Yeah, we're going to be taking a camera with us to Blackpool. We're going to be taking a laptop. We're going to be editing footage while we're there. And then we're going to upload it and hopefully give
you
a taste
of
Blackpool.
And you're going to see that in a few seconds. And hopefully we'll have some good highlights. So we've made it for Blackpool.
Yeah, we're finally here in our temporary studio.
Temporary studio. Spent a lot of money. Borrowed the sofa from the pub and invested 35 quid on eBay for a pop-up.
Yeah, it was very, very exciting. And do you remember a few shows ago, we had a bit of a controversial moment. We were reviewing Switchblade by Dan Harlan.
Yeah, it was very good.
And Eric Jones, it was Twisted.
Yeah.
And I gave Twisted Worker of the Week, and then right at the end of the show, you changed your mind on it.
I withdrew my Worker of the Week.
And I was really annoyed, because I knew that Twisted was better than that.
Well, that's what you said.
No, Twisted was way better than Dan Harlan.
Yeah, you said that.
It was way better. And I've got a way of proving it to you.
No.
I'm going to prove to you right now that Twisted is better than anything Dan Harlan can do.
Right, okay.
And my plan is here right now. I'd like to introduce to the Wizard Product Review audience, the one, the only, Eric Jones.
Eric Jones. I've been set up, haven't I?
Yeah.
There we go. Come in between us. There we go. There's already enough rumours flying around without you putting your arms around me. Just ask Joe Monty. There we go. Although the body language is favouring your side, Craig,
yeah,
so
I'm
quite comfortable with that.
It's the coin guy.
You've got very nice chunky thighs, though. I do like that, Eric. Right, okay. So do you need a table? Do you need to do some...
Well, yeah.
And what's this drink you keep drinking? And you've had like three of these things.
Oh,
can you share? Can we get this over? Yeah, what's in this?
This don't sniff is... it, you'll collapse.
What is it?
Battery acid.
He's had like three of these, and we've never heard of this drink.
Actually, when I was in Florida last weekend, my good friend Kostya Kimlat shared this with me.
Right.
This is Jack Daniel's vodka, and it should be orange juice. I'm sorry.
That is orange juice.
It should be cranberry juice. Yeah. But it's called the Chernobyl.
Well, in England, Blackpool, we have pints. Pints and half pints, and that's pretty much it.
I must say, it's very difficult with you here, but I think on the day I was, not that impressed with Twister. In fact, one of the things that bothered me was your patter. And I've got a bit of a bone pick with you right now.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Have you ever been to England before?
What's all this?
No, I've never been to... This is my first time to England.
First time in England. Did you or did you not say, as part of your patter... You know, that should be genuine at all time for your theatrical audience.
Yeah.
Did you not say, when I went to England, I learned this move off?
I did not say when I went to England. I said I learned it from a guy across the water in England.
So you were on Skype then, were you?
Please.
You're on,
you want to run it back? Should we run it back?
Dave, let's just have a listen to that.
I spent 5 years of my life learning how to do that in one trick. Now, as I became a little more mature in the world of magic, I studied other artists. Another guy from over across the water in the UK, his name is Guy Hollingworth.
I think there's the proof for you there, Dave.
Right, okay, so you're on Skype with Guy Hollingworth. That's what we believe, right, okay. Now, the idea is that you've got to try and convince me. Now, I've never seen Twisted performed by the master up close. So
master, okay.
So are you gonna do it for me now?
Yeah, sure. I'll do one of the effects from it. It's a little cramped, not exactly optimal performing conditions, but
is
I'll
the camera
show you.
Okay.
Whoa. Oh yeah. Actually, you might want to take those off the sticks.
I found the show. There we go. Get it off the sticks.
So it's a trick with the King of Spades, the King of Clubs, the King of Diamonds, and the King of Diamonds. What the
So okay, we can bleep that.
All right, so
regular deck
of 78 playing cards.
Exactly. Would you mind just taking any card out of the pack? The card you choose is the one we will use. We'll get these out of the way.
I like that
rhyming pattern.
The card Perfect. You will use. What was that again? I need to write that down.
I don't know. It's been the Chernobyls all night. So there's the card. So we've got the four kings, and then of course, that's actually an interesting card. You keep your eyes on the three black cards. Of course, the two black kings and then the black queen. But it's not about race. Just remember that as well. So we'll leave those cards here. And if you don't mind, just hold on to the red kings for just a moment. Perfect. All you have to do is keep your eyes on that face down card, the queen. It's going to travel from here to here in a matter of seconds.
No way.
Whoa.
It's interesting.
That is...
That is
just stunning.
Do you know what? When you have it done in your hands, it's brilliant.
Pardon? It's kind of weird. Well, that's what you said.
It's brilliant. It's fantastic. Okay, Dan Harlan. Dan Harlan's not here. You are. I'm giving it back. Half worker of the week. We will return it to you.
Full worker of the week.
Full worker of the week
officially
for Twisted.
Eric Jones, worker of the week for Twisted.
What and thanks for joining us. Can we just ask, have we got anything more coming out from Eric Jones that you're allowed to talk about?
I do have a couple of projects in the works. Unfortunately, I can't really talk about them here and now, but there is going to be a lot more from Eric Jones in 2011.
And talk a bit about what's out at the moment. Obviously, we know Twisted's out. You've been demoing that at the convention, that sort of thing.
Twisted. Also, there's my 3 DVD set, An Extension of Me, which
that
also comes with that.
That's not magic for magicians, is it?
No, it's directly out of my working repertoire.
Is there anything with an out-to-lunch principle?
No.
What Dave's wanting to know is, do you have any work on the Hippity Hobbity Rabbits?
Remember the projects we were talking about earlier?
I'm not that bad. So, Extension of Me, a bit more about that.
Extension of Me, it comes 3 DVDs, 18 tricks, 22 complete items. It comes with the karate coin. It's my proudest moment.
I've watched this an awful lot, and we've never actually looked at it on the show, but the production values are so slick.
Yeah. What about the
really
tricks?
Are.
Who cares about the production values? What about the tricks
are
on
amazing.
There?
Amazing. He does a 3-fly with just 3 coins. No gimmicks, no extras. He has 3 coins, and they go from one hand to the other hand, like 3-fly, but he's not using any extra coins. He's not using any gimmicks.
Sounds
he's a machine.
Good.
He really is. Seriously. I he does the most visual karate
coin
I've
ever
seen.
So we're going to have this on the show. How come you've not shown me this, if it's that good?
You've just answered your own question.
You're keeping it for yourself, aren't you?
Yeah, exactly. And plus it's coins. Come on. He was saying to me earlier, Eric Jones, all magic for magicians.
No, I didn't say that.
It was like, does Eric Jones have a sponge ball routine?
I didn't say that, no.
Which you do. And it's really, really good.
You have a sponge ball routine?
You do? Yes, I do.
Really? Yeah. On that 3 DVD set, he has a sponge ball routine.
I'll have to go and have a look at that. Well, thank you very much for joining us. Eric Jones, who's now off to get pissed at the bar on Chernobyls.
Guys, thank you for having me.
Thank you very much, Eric.
Thank you so much,
it's
Eric.
A pleasure meeting you both.
Eric Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Well, occasionally we upset people on the show, don't we?
It does happen.
We have been known to provoke sort of controversy on the Magic Cafe, and certain people have gone off on their own and responded in their own special way.
They have, and we did something on the show quite a while ago.
Yeah,
and we got a lot of letters saying that we were wrong.
Yeah, we were wrong. Yeah,
and that was, if you ever saw it, we reviewed the Nomad Pad.
Can I just say, Craig's using the word "we" quite a lot here, but actually it was him that came
the
in
magic
for a lot.
Partners
of
were in this together.
Criticism. Okay. Okay. Yeah, we're magic partners.
In this together. Yeah. Okay, we reviewed the Nomad Pad.
The Nomad Pad. We had a big problem with that.
But we thought it was very good.
The pad was very good. In fact,
It could have been worker. The only reason it wasn't is because the trailer.
Do you reckon he heard that bit?
I think he might have.
Right, okay.
The trailer that advertised it on the internet, it exposed the workings of the whole thing, and we said that it was not a very good idea, and I seem to
In fact, don't tone it down. What did you actually say?
You
look straight into that camera, that very same camera, and you said...
I said, Matthew, you're an idiot.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Matthew Bick. Woo! Woo-hoo!
Please grab a seat, Matthew.
We love the fact that you've come on the show and actually had the balls to join us right now.
As opposed to like putting your own review show online and like not...
And put out your own... He looks pretty angry,
nice to...
I don't know much about body language, but this looks pretty stressed right now. Did you take the review pretty well, Matthew?
Ouais, je pense que vous aussi vous êtes des gros cons stupides, mais c'est pas très grave. Ce que j'aimerais bien, c'est essayer de argumenter.
I kind of agree, to be honest. That's how I was thinking about the whole thing as well.
But was it you or was it that guy?
You don't speak French.
Unfortunately.
No. Okay, that's why you're still talking to me. So, what was your point?
Besides
the fact that I'm the stupid guy.
Okay, well...
You know, you're the first guy I met that say I was stupid.
Really?
Yeah. You're
right, well... I mean,
you're the only one that is still alive.
Right! Okay, just hold that thought for 1 second. Right. Hmm? Yeah. Well, let's talk about the Nomad Pad.
Yeah.
It's really... Did you hear me when I said it was really good?
Yeah, I was really pleased.
And I'd just like to point out, before on the show, we reviewed a packet trick of yours, Reversible, and we liked that as well.
I like that as well, Matthew.
Yeah, we both like that. We thought that was really good. But I just thought that the trailer and the way it was put out on the internet.
Whose idea was the trailer, Matthew?
Yeah, because in all seriousness now.
That's right. You give me a bit of that defensive body language as well. Because I'm with this guy. We're magic partners.
So you think
it was a bad idea, that trailer.
You think it was a bad idea.
I think it was a bad idea.
Yeah, it was my idea.
I think you exposed magic on YouTube and it's there in the public domain and it shouldn't have been done. I believe that. I believe Craig. Yeah, I agree with him 100%.
If it was right, I will say you're right. But I did not expose it on YouTube. All my tricks are on YouTube,
yes.
But not this one, because I explain how the method is.
Yeah.
I just put it on my website where only magician can find it.
Well, that's
because,
not bad.
Because, that's not
because
bad. We didn't know that.
That's why I'm here to explain to you. So if you want to find the trailer, you need to...
How did it end up on YouTube?
You need to tap Matthew Bish on your computer. And if you tap Matthew Bish, you're obviously a magician.
But you're putting up a good argument. It was on YouTube.
I don't put it on YouTube. Shops, because they want to sell it, put it on YouTube. But it's
the problem
not
is
my
you're
fault.
A victim of your own success. It's one of the best peak devices to come out in the last 50 years. Every magic dealer in the world wants to stock it. Obviously, in order to
Spreadwave, which is genius, not think if I produce a video, every magic shop in the world's going to put it online?
Okay, because I think when you give $100 to get a product,
yeah,
you must have an idea how it works. Because too many times, and it happens to you also, you put $100 on the product and it's a bad product.
But happened?
Now you see, if you would look it on my website, you see it's a product that you will like to buy it.
As a marketing tool,
yeah,
I think it's genius. As a way of marketing it to magicians, it's genius because the pad itself is so clever. The pad is so clever. And when you see how the thing works and how easy it is to work, you want to buy it. In fact, people got in touch with us in the show and they said, we saw the trailer and we've bought it just on the basis of the trailer. So as a marketing it works.
But what about as certain people on forums have mentioned, the art of magic that is being destroyed here?
Destroyed with magicians. When you have the demo on the Blackpool Convention, they show you how it works. It's the same. Going to see it on my website or showing it on the
different
convention.
There's 3,000 guys up the road there, Matthew, and they paid 80 quid to come in. YouTube's just a click away.
I did not put it on YouTube. If the idiot part is to get it on YouTube, I agree with you. It's an idiot to find this demo on YouTube. But just find Matthew Bish, I did not put it on YouTube. And I asked people to not put it on YouTube.
So are you saying that every magic shop in the world that stocked that product, that put it on YouTube, are you saying they are in fact the idiots?
I think you said it.
I think that makes sense. Matthew Bick is not an idiot. Every single dealer in the world that stocks his product and tries to advertise it... They're idiots.
What have we got on our page at the moment?
John,
better get over to Preloaded.
I think after me, you will have all the dealers in the world to come in and sit here.
John,
if you say
hang on, we've got a dealer right there behind the camera. John, is Matthew's Nomad Pad on World Magic Shop website?
Is the video on there?
Did you put the video on there?
Yes.
John!
Knowing that it would go on YouTube.
You're an idiot!
John Farr, you are an idiot!
You're an idiot, John!
I'd like to retract publicly to the viewers of the Wizard.
We're so sorry, Matthew.
We
it's
are
that
so
guy
sorry.
There.
We're so sorry, Matthew.
Could have shaved first.
Okay, we're best of friends now. It's all good.
So we were at the Session Convention. We bumped into Dynamo, didn't we?
We did. We bumped into Dynamo.
And he found something on our stand, and we hadn't really thought about it. It was the Dynamo deck by Richard Osterlin. And he was pretty upset about it.
He's very annoyed.
Are you serious? Let me have a look. Are these guys taking the piss? Richard Osterlin. Have you seen this? Look, Mr. Guy, Richard Osterlin has put my name onto a deck of cards. He didn't even call me or nothing. You know what? I'm going to let Dave and Craig investigate this on the Wizard product review. Can you get my lawyers on the phone, please?
Well, Craig, we've been joined now by Magic Royalty.
Literally the master of mentalism himself.
And he just proved it. He just proved it a few minutes ago at the bar. You're going to see some footage
And you're not going to believe it. It's the most amazing thing I've ever seen.
I think it was one of the most incredible things I've seen ever at a Blackpool Magic convention. And I saw it, and you guys are going to see it in a few minutes' time. It was absolutely incredible. More on that very shortly. We've been joined by Richard Osterlin, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Hey, thank you.
Now, before we get into this, Dave, there are issues that we need to address.
We need to address this because we've tracked you down at the convention.
Mm-hmm. Dragged you out the Ruskin.
Dragged me out, yep. Hit me over the head with a blackjack, and when I came to, here I was.
I didn't think you'd notice that. And we did it for a reason. We've got a friend, I don't know if you've heard of him, his name's Dynamo.
Yes, I've heard.
Little guy, raps a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Does hip-hop.
Busts out some moves, that sort of thing.
Kind of does fancy shuffles. Now, he's a little bit annoyed, isn't he, Dave?
He's pretty upset, and he asked us to actually get in touch with you because you're using his name.
Yeah, and I've got the evidence here.
There's the evidence.
Richard Osterlin, and that's you.
Well, I just got one thing to say about that.
Right.
What kind of name is Dynamo? That's not a noun. That's an adjective.
I would watch it.
This guy's name's got to be noun.
This guy's a little
in this
bit straight.
It would be Deck.
Well, you know, he's kind of our answer to David Blaine.
In fact, I think actually it was David Blaine that gave him the name Dynamo.
I think it was. Yeah.
I do believe that is the case. Now, I don't know. Whenever we see you on these L&L DVDs, right? You're normally dressed very smartly in a suit. I notice you've got these brand new trainers on. You've got
really
the jeans.
Yes,
you've got this like hoodie thing going on. Are you sure you're not going to turn yourself into Dynamo and start combining hip hop with mentalism?
Well,
do you want to premiere this new act now on the Wizard Product Review, Hip Hop and Mentalism?
First of all, this is how we dress in Kentucky.
Okay. Right, okay.
This is how I dress 99% of the time. And Dynamo, I'm kidding you. You know that, of course. As a matter of fact, we had come up with a different name for this, and then we found out somebody had already used the name with another deck of cards, so we switched.
But didn't you know that already?
Yeah, you should have done
that.
Smart
guy. Gonna have to hit me over the head again with the blackjack. This was the second name. We had a different name for it, and I forgot what the first name was, but it was already taken. We thought we were safe with Dynamo. I didn't know that we were going to have some.
So what is it? Can you do it?
I think he might be okay with it if you can show everyone what it is.
Okay, sure. It's a lot of things, but let me just do one thing with it, okay? Get rid of the wrapper here. Just one of these new mandolin bag.
Yeah,
that's very good. Nicely made cards. Mm. And here, if you don't mind, we'll get rid of the extra cards.
Okay.
And all right, just deck of cards. They come already mixed up like this, okay? And I'm going to mix them up a little bit more.
They're all different.
Kind of hard on the sofa here, but we'll do our best here. Okay, Greg, would you take them and give them a cut like this here?
Okay, yep, no problem.
Okay, I'm not looking, I'll look away.
Okay.
It's not marked, they're not marked cards. No. Cut them again if you want, it's up to you.
Yep.
Give him one more cut for good measure.
Got it.
Okay, now what I need you to do, I'm looking away the entire time. Slide three cards off, it's face down, right, the deck?
Yeah, that's
slide three cards off the top.
Okay.
And put them into your pocket here. Don't look at them.
I'm shoving them between my legs right now.
Oh, you know, yeah, put them in your shirt pocket if you can't put them in your...
Okay. Can you get that open?
That's it.
There we go. Cool, hang up.
Yeah, put them in your shirt pocket.
Done.
Okay, that's it. Okay, was that fair?
You've not seen those.
No, I didn't see a thing.
Give me the case, as a matter of fact. Okay, we'll just put the rest of the deck in the case.
Now
that's about as fair as we can get, right? Wouldn't you say?
Yep.
Okay.
That seems really fair to me.
That sounds really fair, yeah. Scarily fair.
Okay. I'm going to count to three, and I'm going to ask you to reach in your pocket and pull out one of those cards. As fast as you can.
Okay.
As fast as you can. So are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Listen carefully to me. On the count of three, I want you to reach in your pocket as fast as you can and pull out the two of diamonds. One, two, three, do it.
What the hell?
What?
What just happened? On the count of three, one, two, three, pull out the six of spades. One, two, three, now.
I'm doing it. Oh, shut up. How does he do this?
Now listen carefully. You have your choice here. You have your choice here.
Right. Yeah.
You can pull out any card you want. Okay. But what I'd like to see you pull out is, how about we go with the Ten of Hearts? One, two, three. Pull out the Ten of Hearts.
Oh, that's just amazing. That's just brilliant.
Good job.
Oh,
I
no,
think,
that was.
I think you're psychic.
I think I am. I must be.
That's just amazing. I was. Yeah, suddenly that's going to stay down there, I think, just the side of there.
No, that was brilliant. You say it's a combination of things.
Yeah, that's only one. That's only about one of a dozen different things that you can do with this deck. What I've done is I've taken some very old principles that a lot of modern magicians don't even know about, and I combined them. And I've got some thoughts in there of my own, too, where I've updated, like I did with 13 Steps, you know, how I've taken some of the classics and tried to make them a little bit my own.
There's a lot of people that think, you know, you shouldn't go back to the classics and study the classics. A lot of modern magicians think you shouldn't bother with the classics.
Don't do cups just, and bulls, don't do this, don't do that.
Yeah, just like if you're a musician, you should never play a G major seventh chord because, my goodness, that's classic. It's been done before, you know. To me, that's silly. You know, that's a basics. Well, that's a root. That's a groundwork.
I heard that you were revisiting a lot of the classics in a comedy club recently. Is that right?
A comedy club. Yeah, we recorded a new set of videos called Richard Osterlin Live Without a Net, because we just did it in a comedy club, one take with people off the street. And yeah, I went back and I used a lot of classic mentalism, things that I hadn't done in years, in 25, 30 years. And, you know, it's... audience loved it. I bet you when it comes out, a lot of mentalists will look at it and say, wow, where'd you get that new stuff, you know? And I'm using stuff like
so old as new.
Yeah, exactly.
Fantastic.
Exactly.
And so when's that going to be out?
Oh, I expect within 2 months that'll probably be out. So
thank you so much for giving me your time this weekend. Now, a bit of a treat for you. If that hasn't convinced you to get in your car and drive to... It's Wednesday right now when this show is going out. We're filming this on the Blackpool weekend, obviously. Can you remember where you are on Wednesday night?
Wolverhampton.
Wolverhampton. Get in your car now.
And then tomorrow
night. And get over to Wolverhampton.
Tomorrow night back in Blackpool.
Blackpool.
Blackpool, yeah. If you fancy going to the
lecture
in Blackpool as well.
You've got to see this man lecture. You know, the Dynamo deck, I'm giving it 98%.
I'll agree with that. That was absolutely unbelievable. Mind reading doesn't get any more incredible and any more direct than that. That was absolutely incredible.
It was an honour.
Like we said, it's been an honour to have you on the Wizard Product Review sofa. A real treat for the viewers. And we got another treat right now, which is something we saw a few minutes ago at the bar, performed by Richard Osterlin.
The man.
I'll tell you something, it's sort of become my trademark. And, you know, I've done this over the years for magicians and celebrities all around the country. No one here is American but me, right?
Right.
Okay, so because of that, I apologize. I'm going to have to ask you to do something. I normally would never do this. If you've seen my videos and my new ones coming out, you'll see that I actually do this twice, where I borrow coins from the audience.
Yeah.
I've got a mixture of coins. Grab any American penny from that bunch. There's a bunch of them in there.
Just American penny.
Yeah, and it's got to be an American penny because...
Yeah, got it.
You know, okay, is that one fine with you? You can use a different one if you want.
Is that a penny? Sorry.
That's a penny, yeah. That's what we call a Lincoln penny. I could maybe do one of your half pence. I don't know, but I'm going to do it with my own coin because... or my own denomination coin because I feel comfortable doing it with that. Any U.S. penny will work pretty much. Before I begin, does anyone have a key or something to scratch it with? Or a knife or something with that you can put a little mark on both sides?
The room key for the Fairview Hotel. Do you want me to do that now?
Yeah, just scratch it on both sides. And while you're doing that, I'm just taking off my watch and my ring just so I won't have anything on my hands.
Yeah, I can see that on both sides, Richard.
Yeah, both sides. I'm going to get elaborate here, too. I'm going to roll up my sleeves, okay? We'll make it good.
Yep.
Okay.
Can see that?
Yeah, that looks good to me.
Right. Now let me do this like this. You got the camera going over here?
Yeah.
Here we go. Now, we can switch coins and use a different coin, but I swear to you, this is just an American penny. Anyone like to check it out?
It looks good to me.
That's the same one as well.
It's just an American penny. And like I said, I'm going to have to try this before I leave with some of the smaller copper coins you have. I do know that with American coins, I have to be careful. Any coin beyond 1980 is usually this Cooper nickel type compound. It's like zinc. It's But the older coins, and you can tell them right away from the way they look, like this is 1970 something, that's pretty much pure copper. Watch it close. Yeah, that's right. Get right on it.
Oh my God.
What?
Oh, jeez.
Oh my God.
Okay, now you can see it's gone. There's the marks on the back. That's a pretty, it's warped. It's not really bent, you see, it's
warped. It is bent.
It really, that's definitely bent.
No, that's definitely bent.
No.
That's mad.
That's just insane.
I have to tell you, most of these shows that I do are corporate shows, and a lot of my clients are people like Nike and Starter Sports. And when I do shows at these places, they usually have athletes, professional athletes there, football players and basketball players and wrestlers. And I've seen some of the strongest men in the world watch me do this and take a coin themselves and try to bend it by strength. I have yet to meet anyone who can bend any small coin like this, a penny, by strength. I'm going to bend it a little bit more and give it to you to keep, okay? Ready? Here we go. Watch.
Oh, geez.
Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
This is happening. Look at it now.
Dave.
Build a church here.
That's it.
Build the hell is going on there?
That's it. Beating at your own game.
I don't believe it. I don't believe it. It's not just bent, it's completely warped. Like warped,
yeah.
That is nuts.
And
can we keep that?
It's signed. Well, it's marked. It's exactly the same mark. It's exactly the same scratches as well. That was absolutely incredible.
That was unbelievable.
Thank you.